one in all. It's the 19th of May and a nice bit of sunshine to greet us this morning. So first job on, we're going to clear a bit of ground up, which will eventually be the home for the outdoor tomatoes.
There's a brown cauliflower here, what's just left, and the dregs of the purple broccoli. I've had more than enough of that now, so I think it's time to rip the lot out. Originally I was going to put the sweet peas in here, but I think it'll be a more suitable place for the tomatoes. Okay, that's a quick tidy up of that area. That's as far as it will go for the time being. As I say, I think the Crimson Crush tomatoes will go in here, but they're not ready yet, so I'll have plenty of time to prepare the bed a bit better. Moving across to here, this is the Brassica bed, which I should be planting out within the next day or two. I'm plagued by these crop of last year's potatoes. I'm coming up all over the place, and I religiously dug this bed out when I fetched the potatoes, and it's been well rotivated this year, but still they keep coming up. And it does, you know, bear the question, is it worth growing potatoes in the ground now, because you can never get them out. And so it could be possibly next year I might be going totally over to buckets for the potatoes. We'll see. In the meantime, I've just pricked out a couple of trays of celery that's laid them self-blanching. There's 224 cell trays there. I've got here some tubers really, the Jerusalem artichokes. It was kindly given to me by Terry King at Malvern Show. If you haven't been across Terry's channel, nip across now and sign up, because he grows some weird and wonderful stuff, and he's always doing different trials, one thing and another. Anyway, Terry's put his in the ground. I've decided to try mine in the bucket because they have got a reputation of doing a bit of spreading and appearing year after year, so I'm erring on the side of caution. And so I'll plant them like I would a normal potato. I assume that that's the root end, so I'll drop it in line with the angles first. Down it goes, and pointing in there. Another one there. I'll do it like the potatoes, and then I'll put another layer of soil on and do the other one 90 degrees. No surprise, the rain come and beat us again, but I managed to get them in the bucket in the end. Here's another gimme from one of the plot elders, another something first for me. It's a Cape gooseberry. I've never ever had one of those, grown one before, so I need to do a bit of reading up on that and see what to expect. Hello folks, I've had a bit of a lazy day today, I was doing. Half past three now, I've just decided to plant the brassicas out. First plants to go in for 2016 is the tray of broccoli over there called Iron Man. There's 10 plants in all. So there we have the 12 Iron Man calabrese safely bed. The little white hoops, well, I've just put over, so I can pop a net over until I've planted the old bed out. All that is, it's UPVC windowboard. It's this sort of stuff really, what the windowsills out is. What I've done, I've ripped a strip down on my table saw about an inch wide, and it makes them really flexible, so it's great for just popping a net over the top or a bit of fleece. The weather's a bit iffy today, it's windy, bit of showers, then the sun will come out. So continuing on from yesterday, I'm going to try and get another cheeky little 10 summer cabbages in. You can see that the root ball's quite good on this one. Let's give it a good firming in. Get the other 9 to go now. Just got the last one in, guess what, down comes the rain again, so in between the next break I'll try and get a cover over. Morning all, we haven't quite beat the birds, but we've beat everybody else. Lovely and fresh this morning, we had some great rain yesterday, which will make the weeding a bit easier. We'll just have a little stroll down the plot. This is the temporary marquee that I lashed up after I got the last of the 10 cabbages in yesterday, because they say the rain did come and it was quite heavy. But that'll see it okay until I get the rest of the bed planted out. You know, I might remember a few episodes back there where I planted the parsnips. Well, I'm still under here in the tubes. We'll have a quick look. That rain should have done it a bit good. There's lots of weeds in here, but as you can see, the parsnips are starting to come up. So I'll give that a few more days. Sort the weak from the strong out, whittle them down, and in the meantime, I can get the hoe in between, and with the collars round, safely knowing that I'm not going to damage the parsnips. Spring onions are looking fine. So is the beetroot. Actually, I had a couple of radish yesterday. And there's the lettuce. And so the web's wonderful, and the little gem. For those of you of a squeamish nature, look away for the next few seconds. So I've caught one of my furry friends. In my last video, I had a couple of comments asked regarding the beds, the way they've set up with the Enviromesh frames. This is from Mike Brotherton and Sheila 6325, I think it is. So, just show you, have a closer look. The four main beds are made up of standard builders scaffold planks, which are 3.9 metres. That's just under 15 feet 10 in old money. And the bed is actually 1.5 scaffold planks long, and the way I've joined it is by using another piece of scaffold there and actually screw through the boards to join it, so it's actually 1.5 scaffolds long in total. The bed is that then is subdivided up into three, as you can see there and there, so you get three equal beds. And there's four sets of beds, so that's 12 individual beds in total. The joints on the planks, I've staggered them, so
on this one here. On the other side, it's diagonally opposite into that corner there. That's how then makes the frames interchangeable, so it doesn't matter which side of the bed they go on, they'll actually fit. The width of each bed is around about 8 feet. How I come to that was I was undecided which width to make the beds. However, making them any shorter, I could have got more beds in, but it means more paths, which is reducing the growing space. So I found 8 foot to be a happy medium. This is a couple of frames actually still in construction at the moment. It needs another coat of wood stain at least once more. There's one there and one there. The frames which fit on the ends are universal across all the beds. But the sides, there's two designs, one for the end beds and one for the centre beds, and I'll just explain what it is. This one here is for the end bed, and if you notice, the two long vertical legs on each side have got a leg sticking down, which enables the frame to be pushed into the soil. This one here is for the centre bed, and if you notice, one of the legs which goes into the soil is actually set inward slightly, and that's to allow for the joining board between the two planks that I explained earlier, as you can see there. You can see better now what I mean with having the one leg offset to accommodate for the joining plate. If we look there, the leg is just inside the plate. And so because I put the plates on opposite corners of the beds, like there and there, it allows the frame to be used on both sides of the bed. When the frame is fully pressed down, this bottom rail here rests on top of the plank and it gives it a nice firm support like that. The frame then is finally covered with Enviromesh. It's fixed at the moment with just staples. I did try using a hot glue gun and that worked for a while, but I think as it gets wet, the glue actually lets the Enviromesh pop off in a few places, so I ended up going along with the staple gun. What I'll probably do in future, or maybe modification to these, is add a strip of this is a UPC PVC window board that I've cut down. I use it for hoops and plant labels. I might put a strip of that across the top and put a few screws through and hold it in with that as well. With the four sides in place, I just added a couple of extra screws here and then secured them with a zip tie, cable tie, and that actually holds the top part together. One more final thing, there's two strips go across the top with one screw in, held there, and across here, the other side of the board, and that there is just to stop the top from flexing. Then you just pop a sheet of Enviromesh over the top. I've got elastic around mine that needs replacing. Over the year it's actually withered and gone slack now, so I'll just put a new piece of elastic in. This is obviously me elephant garlic, normal garlic. So the height of the frames are 20 inches. I suppose I could have made them 24, looking at the elephant garlic now, which is poking up a bit higher, but whatever suits you is what you grow. So that's it. I hope it's explained it a little bit better. The sunflowers keep flopping over now. I think the pots are a bit too small for them. The weather's changed again this morning. Although the sun's coming out now, it's noticeably much colder. Then I've had to wrap up accordingly. Anyway, what I'm going to do, there's 9 sunflowers here. I'm going to put 3 stakes in 3 rows of the main between the main crop of potatoes, and then we'll plant them out. That's the 9 stakes in, so let's get the sunflowers in now.
9 Titan sunflowers. There they are in their final home. They'll droop a bit for the first 2 or 3 days because sunflowers don't like their roots being disturbed or anything like that. But once we have a bit of sunshine on and possibly, well, inevitably, the rain, they'll soon pick up and the heads will be poking up high again.
Morning all. Join me on my morning stroll. I did say in the last video that we'd be planting the hanging baskets up in this episode, but it was while I was putting the sunflowers out yesterday I realised there's other jobs keep cropping up, and so rather than rush things or have an episode which is hour and a half, the hanging baskets will be in the next episode, but they definitely will, because I just popped into the greenhouse just and I'll put a clip on now. You should see it. Is the begonias are really into flower now and I can't really leave them much longer in the pots, so they'll be definitely being done very shortly. In the meantime, I've still got a lot of brassicas to put out, and also while we've got the next few days looks pretty promising, I want to try and get the metal paint onto the framework of the garden bench as well, so there'll be a few short clips I should tag on to the end of this.
It looks as if the sunflowers have settled back in after their disturbance yesterday. A quick little job we can get out of the way is to get the Zebrune shallots planted out. These are done in cell trays, as you can see, but some of them have got 2 and 3 plants in there. I'm not going to try bother splitting them up. I'll just put them in as is and we'll see how they grow. So that's a couple of rows of banana shallots in. There's about 18 or 19 in each row. I've got a few left out, but not enough for a full row, so I'm not sure where I'm going to put those yet. I decided to thin them out in the end and I managed to get 3 rows, around about 50. A bit close together, but I've never grown them before. We'll see how they go. I did say earlier that we was going to have a go at painting the ironwork on the bench, which I'm doing the refurb on. I've wire brushed that, so I've got all the rust off, loose flaky stuff. That's ready to go now. The paint I'm using is Wix's version, I suppose, of the famous Hammerite. When I've come to do this job, rather than use one of my decent paint brushes, which to clean this stuff off here is a nightmare unless you buy the proper stuff, I went to my local cheap shop called B&M. Managed to get these little beauts. 10 brushes there, £1.99. Can you believe it? Both of these frames now, if you pardon the expression, are being left out, hung out to dry. While we're in this direction, just have a look at this start of this plot next to mine. This is the one where the people left who we'd got issues with, and unfortunately the allegedly new owner of the plot turns out to be one of our local councillors, and they've been down once or twice, and as you can see, left a lot to be desired. Now that the sunflowers are in place, I've got some rotting manure at the top, so I'll just fill the valleys up and the sunflowers then they'll take the nutrients out of that as it rots down. This is the morning after the horse manure was put on. So I've topped the valleys up, but as you'll see already, the potatoes are popping through there, lovely. And the sunflowers have perked up. So I think that's a good job.
I did say I was going to do the baskets in this one, but I've shot that much footage, it's going to be a really long episode, so I promise the baskets will be in the next episode. In fact, I've just started them. So until the next time, I'll see you again. Bye for now.